This is the Faith Fight Podcast. Today, we're talking about fighting for your marriage. Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of the Faith Fight Podcast. I hope that you're having a blessed day. My name is Chris Crary, and I'm here to help you get your prayers answered, to encourage you to grow from glory to glory, and to ultimately assist you in achieving your God-given purpose. Thank you for taking time out of your day to listen. You could be doing anything right now with your ears, listening to anything else out there, but you have chosen to listen to this podcast, so I say thank you, and I pray that this is a blessing to you. If this is your first time listening, remember the podcast is available on all of the major podcasts and apps. It's available on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Amazon Music, and on Audible, or wherever you listen to podcasts. All you need to do is just search the Faith Fight Podcast, and you'll be able to subscribe and follow this podcast so that you receive every episode that I release on a Sunday morning. That's the new release date for 2024 and beyond. Sunday morning, every new episode will come out, and you can listen to it and be encouraged and be blessed through the Faith Fight Podcast. And I want to let everyone know that all of the past episodes are also available. And I've been doing the podcast for 5 years. So that's 5 years worth of episodes that cover various topics, whether you are praying, believing God for a new job, praying or asking God for help with your children or with a problem that you have. If you need encouragement or insight with regards to spiritual warfare, I've covered all of these episodes in the past, and all you need to do is just scroll back and look at the different topic titles. You could even read the description of the episode, and you can download and listen to any one of those past episodes. They will be a blessing to you. And just before we get started with this episode, I want to let you know about a new podcast that has recently launched called Strategize Your Life with Pastor Dean and Jacqueline Richards. This podcast is providing discussions and strategies for individuals to achieve their natural giftings, believe that they can obtain greatness, and overcome any obstacles preventing them in pursuing their purpose. It's a powerful podcast, and it will encourage you to reach new heights. I've placed links in the description so you can listen to this podcast and be blessed by the ministry of Pastor Dean and Pastor Jacqueline. Again, the podcast is called Strategize Your Life, and you can find it on all of the major podcasts and apps. Now, there will always be a battle to keep the peace in your marriage. The enemy always attacks Christian couples because a successful, happy, God-centered marriage produces a successful, God-centered, happy family and successful kids that go on to do great things in the world for God's kingdom. If the enemy can break up the marriage, then there is a likelihood that the kids won't get the best foundation to become all that God has called them to be. So we need to fight for our marriage by standing on God's word. Today I'm going to go over some verses that you can apply to yourself and your marriage to keep it strong and whole. First of all, I'll read Ephesians 5:33. It says, "Nevertheless, let each one of you in particular so love his own wife as himself, and let the wife see that she respects her husband." Now, this verse gives us insight on two key things that a husband and wife need to do for each other. Husbands need to show love towards their wife, and wives need to respect their husbands. What does that look like? Now, this will be different for each couple, but the only way to find this out is to have a conversation and answer the question, how can I show you more love, or how can I show you more respect? And when you get the answer from the other spouse, then just do it. As long as it lines up with scripture, commit to doing what needs to be done in your marriage so that it can be a blessing to your spouse. And I'll read Ephesians 5:25-30 next. It says, "Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for her, that he might sanctify and cleanse her with the washing of water by the word, that he might present to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that she should be holy and without blemish. So husbands ought to love their own wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. For no one ever hated his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it, just as the Lord does the church. For we are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones." How should a man love his wife? Number one, he should be willing to sacrifice everything for her. Number two, he should make her well-being of primary importance. Ask her how she's doing and ensure her mental, emotional, and physical needs are met. Number three, he should care for her as he cares for his own body. No wife needs to fear submitting to a man who treats her in this way. And men, you might be hearing me say this, but yes, love your wife as Christ loves the church and sacrifice for it. Just as we responded to that amazing love that Jesus showed us, your wife will respond to your sacrificial love for her. God will strengthen you and bless you for being obedient to his word. And I'll read Mark 10 verse 9. It says, "Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate." So back in this time when this scripture was written, women were often treated as property. Marriage and divorce were regarded as transactions similar to buying and selling land. But Jesus condemned this attitude, clarifying God's original intent that marriage brings oneness. And this is found in Genesis 2:24. So Jesus held up God's ideal for marriage and told his followers to live by this. And this still holds true today. Women are not property, but husbands and wives were made one when they were married, and that oneness should not be broken. Therefore, in order to be obedient to this verse, spouses need to be in agreement in the oneness and permanence of marriage. Regardless of the issue, work it out. And if you need to see pastoral counseling, you should do that. There's nothing wrong in seeing a counselor to get help in your marriage. And depending on the issue, this might be hard to do, but the next verse that I'm going to share should fix that problem and help you to overcome that challenge. Colossians 3 verse 13 to 14 says this, "Bear with each other and forgive one another if any of you has a grievance against someone. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity." So we all need to remember that God has forgiven us a great deal. Not only has he forgiven us, but he doesn't hold our past sins against us. We need to have this approach in our marriage. Work out the situation by talking about it and be quick to forgive the other person. And again, if you need help doing this, you can see pastoral counseling to get help to aid that conversation that you have with your spouse. Do not hang the issue over them or hold something back for some time in the future to bring it up for whatever reason. Forget about it and work on being a blessing to your spouse. And if you find it hard, just think about all the times that God has forgiven you for something that you have done, and even that thing that you have done multiple times over and over that you knew were wrong. Apply that same grace to your spouse that God has shown you. Next, I read Proverbs 25, verse 11. It says, "A word fitly spoken is like apples of gold in settings of silver." So what we say can hurt others, but what's also important is how we say it and when we say it. It's important to know when you and your spouse are in the right mindset to have difficult conversations. At times, a difficult conversation is absolutely needed, but if it's done right, it will be a blessing to both of you, and there will be peace and restoration in your household and not tension. And Proverbs 15 verse 18 says, "A hot-tempered person stirs up conflict, but the one who is patient calms a quarrel." So don't wait for an opportunity to start to fight with your spouse. Take the time to relax and cool down. The emotion of the situation can lead you to say or do the wrong things. So pause and think about what you want to say that will bring reconciliation and resolution to the conflict. You don't want to say something that stirs up more conflict in your marriage. After a disagreement, the only goal should be reconciliation and restoration of the peace in your relationship with your spouse. And I'll read 1 Corinthians 13 verse 4 to 8 next. It says, "Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. But where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away." So if you think marriage is all about hugs and kisses, then I think you still may be in the honeymoon phase. Marriage is tough because two people from two different backgrounds and upbringings are coming together under the same roof trying to build a life together. Now, there will be challenges for husband and wife to adjust to this new life together that they're starting. Now, this verse can be looked at in a different way if you interject yourself instead of the word love into this verse. For example, are you patient with your spouse? Are you kind? Are you being envious or prideful? And so on. So you can use this method to check yourself against the word of God and allow the Holy Spirit to work on your heart concerning your relationship. If you and your spouse can use this verse to check your own hearts, then chances are both of you can grow and use the Word of God to mature and have a God-centered marriage that will last for a very long time. And we're going to pray right now that marriages will last. So if you're doing anything that requires your attention, keep your eyes open, and I'm going to pray and you can agree with me through saying amen. Heavenly Father, thank you. Thank you for your love and your faithfulness, all that you have done in us and through us. And I thank you for this opportunity and this privilege, O God, that we may come before your throne of grace, O holy God, and pray to you and present our request to your throne of grace right now. I humbly come before you, Lord God, and I ask that you would cleanse me, purify me, O God, and touch every single part of my being. I pray, Father God, that you will forgive me if I have fallen short, and every other person listening right now, have mercy upon us, Lord God, for we are sinful, Lord God, but it's because of Jesus that we can approach your throne of grace right now. And I pray right now for every single married couple out there, Lord God. I thank you, Father God, that your word is true, Lord God, that who you join together, let no one separate. So, Father, I pray that every single marriage be strengthened right now by the power of your word. And I thank you, Father God, for husbands and wives, Lord God, together being able to communicate and talk to each other, O God, to show, O God, or to explain what love is to the other person and what it means to respect, O God, the other person, Lord God, so that those needs will be met in the relationship, Father God, and that marriages will be strengthened, Lord God. I thank you, Father God. I pray specifically now for the husbands, Lord God. I pray that the husbands, oh God, will love their wives as Christ loved the church. Lord God, that they will sacrifice for their wife and that they will take the steps to inquire on how their wife is doing. And I thank you, Father God, that right now every husband out there will care for his wife as he does his own body. And I give you the praise for this, Lord God. I thank you that you will equip and strengthen the men to do this, just as you strengthened Jesus to die on the cross for our sins, Lord God. I give you the praise and I thank you for this, Lord God. And I give you honor and praise, Lord God, because you have forgiven us much, Lord God. And I thank you, Lord God, that when we have something that our spouse may have done wrong, Lord God, help us to remember to show that grace, O God, and show mercy to our spouse, Lord God, remembering that you have forgiven us much, Lord God, so that we should extend that same forgiveness and grace to our spouse, Lord God. I give you the praise and the thanks for this. And I pray for every single married couple right now that you will give us all discernment and wisdom, Lord God, that we will be able to speak the right words in the right time, Lord God, and in the right way, that it brings reconciliation and restoration of any tension or issues in the household, in a marriage, Lord God. And I thank you, Father, that you will give us wisdom and understanding to do this, Lord God. Give us, oh God, understanding to know, oh God, when we need to take a step back and calm down from a tense emotional conversation, Lord God, so that we may come and approach the situation from a rational thought and a rational perspective, oh God, with our spouses, Lord. And I pray, Lord God, that you will help every single spouse be patient and kind and not boastful, oh God, or proud or dishonor the other person, Lord God, or self-seeking, Father. I pray, oh God, that we will be servants to our spouse, oh God. And I pray that we'll be a blessing to our spouse in all that we do. So I thank you, Father God, and I pray for every single marriage right now, wherever it is, whether it is strong, I pray that you will make it stronger. And if it's on the brink of falling apart, I pray that you will mend, oh God, that relationship. And I lift up every single spouse to you, Lord God. I pray that humility is at the center of every single marriage, Lord God, and submission to your Holy Spirit and to you, Lord God, that you'll be able to flow and be very present in that marriage, Lord God. So I thank you and I commit every single married person, oh God, into your hands, Lord, and I give you the praise and the glory for this. In the name of Jesus, I thank you and I pray. Amen. And that's it for this episode of the Faith Fight Podcast. And if you were blessed by this episode, you can go over to Apple Podcasts. You can subscribe there. You can write a review. And for those of you who have Android phones, you can listen to the podcast through Google Podcasts, Spotify, Amazon Music, and on Audible. Just search the Faith Fight Podcast and you'll be able to find the podcast there. And share this episode with every married couple that you know. If you know of anyone who's going through any marital problems, share this episode with them and have them listen to it with their spouse so that they can be encouraged and meditate on some of the verses that I mentioned and pray together with their spouse. You guys may have heard this, the couple that prays together stays together. So pray with your spouse. And remember to put on the full armor of Christ Jesus every single day and go out and fight the good fight of faith. And you'll hear from me again next week on the Faith Fight Podcast. Something good is going to happen to you today. Be blessed, everyone.